Hey guys, it's Missy. Thank you for watching. For today's video, I wanted to do a makeup tutorial instead of a hair tutorial. Today's look is inspired by spring. It's kind of a pop of pink look and it is a little bit bold. So if you want to wear something a little bit more neutral, you could use the same techniques and use brown shades or more toned down colors. So that is it is a little bit more wearable. Make sure to click the thumbs up if you want to see more makeup tutorials and don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you're new or if you haven't yet. And let's get started. So I'm prepping my eyelid with some concealer to start. And I did already do most of my face makeup just to save some time. For the eyeshadow, I'm using this Carity palette. This is the Rosé All Day. I'm going to start by taking this pink shade. This is Hooray. It's kind of a hot pink matte shade. I'm grabbing, this is actually a concealer brush, a Sigma F70. So since my eyes are so hooded, I want to kind of find my actual crease. Not where my eye creases, but where my brow bone kind of sinks in. So that is where I'm going to place this color. Then I'm just going to place it in the inner corner. I'm going to kind of keep it closer, more tight inside of the area that creases. I don't really want any to come out here. I want it to stay kind of where my eye starts, if that makes sense. Now I'm going to go back to the outer corner and I'm going to kind of bring the line down to the lashes and then kind of feather the color towards the middle just slightly. Once I have the color kind of placed, now I'm going to very carefully blend it. When you have hooded eyes, it's better to use really small, precise brushes. I'm using the Sigma Small Tapered Blending Brush. This is the E45. I'm gonna go back and put on a little bit more of that pink. I didn't blend that line all the way. I'm going to use a different shadow, and so I'm going to just add a tiny bit more pink. So next I'm going to do my lid color, and I'm using this color called Brunch. This is a shimmer shade, it's like a light pink color. I'm just going to kind of pack this in the middle of the lid. Ooh, I love this, it's like a Barbie pink. And I'm using a flat shader brush. This is actually a Carity brush, it's the E28. My son just came in the room and when he saw my eyes, he goes, "Oh, mommy, your eyes are so cute." One of the benefits of having a four-year-old, I guess. We're going to a ranch later today to see baby farm animals because Cohen is obsessed with farm animals. And my eyeshadow is gonna be popping. Okay, as much as I love this, I want a little more. So I'm going to add a little bit of a darker pink. So I think I'm going to do, I want to do Cheer, but I think I'm going to do Fun Day because Fun Day is a matte. So I'm just going to use a little tiny little baby pointer brush, a Real Techniques accent brush. I kind of want to outline the bottom of the pink. So I'm placing it just right here on the inside of the pink, the dark pink. I don't want it to connect, I just want it to come a little farther over. And then I have to do the same thing on the inner part so that they la match. Next I'm going to grab this pale pink shade. This is Bottled Up and it's kind of a matte shade. So I'm going to grab this and I just want to very lightly trace this around the top edge. And I think I'm going to use a teeny tiny brush just for fun. This is a EcoTools smudge brush. Most people do a transition color first, so I guess in a way this is, I'm putting down my transition color, but what I am technically doing is I am blending out the edge of those hot pink colors that I did. This kind of allows me to have a little bit more control over where this color is going, and then I can kind of use it to, in a way, clean up what I have already done. So now I'm going to go back to that E45, and this is a clean brush, and I'm just going to use this to kind of go back over the pink, and I'm kind of blending the pink into, I had set up here with just a powder. I'm feeling the need to just kind of clean up my pinks. So what I'm going to do is I'm gonna go back to, what is this, a concealer brush, the F70 that I laid the pink with. So I'm just blending the pink shimmer shade with kind of the hot pink shades, just ever so gently. Once that's done, we don't want to ruin all of it with eyeliner. So what I'm going to do instead is I'm going to take a brown It's the Urban Decay Glide On Eye Pencil. This is the shade Double Life. So I'm going to tight line to start. So I'm just rubbing this all underneath here. It's really uncomfortable, but it makes such a difference. I don't want to put on a ton, but what I'm going to do is I'm just going to make it thicker in the outer corner, and then I'm going to bring the line down really close to the lashes. One of the tricks with eyeliner is you want to keep it as close to your lashes as possible so that when your eyes are open, you can still see skin from your lash line to your little fold. That's super important. If you have your eyeliner too thick, then literally that entire portion of skin will just be dark eyeliner. Next, I'm doing my mascara. I'm doing my 3 combo. It's the L'Oreal primer, the L'Oreal Lash Paradise, and then the Brooklyn and Bailey. I got my lashes tinted and permed the other day, and now putting on mascara is really difficult. For some reason, the mascara is like more clumpy than normal and does not go on very cleanly. I like having them dyed because I can see them a little bit better. I am not perming them ever again. It is such a pain. I would rather just wake up and curl them myself. See how the top is like all... It can't decide what to do. It just doesn't want to do what everybody else is doing. Mama. Hi, Annie.
What are you doing?
Attempting to put on mascara. What are you doing?
Well, I don't know what I'm doing, though.
We'll go see the farm animals as soon as I'm done. Seriously, somebody come help me. So I went ahead and put on some lashes just because I felt like torturing myself. My lashes are so wonky that I felt like I needed it. And I just put on the Andrea Strip Lashes, either 24 or 12. I can't remember, but they're from Ulta. I'm going to move on to the lower lashes. And I'm basically going to mimic what I did on the top. So I'm just going to do the dark pink, the light pink, and then the dark pink again. As a last step, I'm going to take this really light kind of champagne shimmer shade in the very inner part of my eye just to make that pop a smidge. I don't like it when I feel like my eyeshadows kind of blend out, and so I'm just kind of basically trying to create a barrier right there. For blush, I'm gonna do 2 Tarte blushes. I'm mixing these. One is Party and one is Akiyote, and I just love the way these look. They're very pale pink. I did a lip combo and I feel like it was too mauve-y. My eyes are like so bright. So I'm going to do a pinkier lip, and I'm using the MAC lip liner in Anticipation. And this is like, I think, the pinkiest lip liner that I have. I used to wear this all the time and I haven't in forever. It's kind of dry. Maybe I should throw it away. Okay, hopefully this works. Okay, so for lipstick, I'm using the MAC Cream Cup. I've seen so many girls wear this. I think this is a cool toned lipstick because on me, it just doesn't look very good. But with a warmer lip liner, I'm thinking that it might. I like that a lot more already. So I think I'm done. What do you think? Am I done? So that wraps up today's makeup tutorial. I gotta run really quick and go see those farm animals with Cohen. The place opens right now, so I'm actually really excited. Click the thumbs up if you want to see more makeup tutorials, and make sure to subscribe so you don't miss out on future videos. Click another video. I'm sure they're linked somewhere else. Stay here a little while. Let's be friends. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time.